Hello and a warm welcome to World This Week by Latest Laws. This is a weekly program, so hit the bell icon to get notifications for new videos. My name is Vasvi Bhatia and let's begin with Supreme Court this week.
The Supreme Court, while examining the cognizance abilities of authorities, earlier today questioned the National Dream Tribunal regarding whether or not they will be taking responsibility and provide some solace to victims of pollution-related issues in the absence of a formal application tabled before it. The allegations of Pegasus spyware being used to target opposition leaders, journalists and others are serious if newspaper reports are correct. The Supreme Court said today as it heard a batch of petitions seeking a special probe into the scandal. The Supreme Court ruled that no government can discriminate between practitioners of allopathy and Ayurveda, yoga and naturopathy, Unani, Siddha and homeopathy, and directed the North Delhi Municipal Corporation to pay Ayush practitioners on par with allopathy doctors under the Central Health Scheme. Ayurvedic doctors covered under Ayush are also entitled to the benefit of enhanced superannuation, age of 65 years at par with the allopathic doctors, the apex court said on Tuesday. A bench of Justice L. Nageshwara Rao and Justice Hrishikesh Roy opined that both allopathic and Ayurvedic doctors render service to patients, and on this core aspect, there is nothing to distinguish them. The Supreme Court said that DNA tests cannot be ordered to establish the legitimacy of a child born during the sustenance of a marriage if there is no primary evidence of adultery. The Supreme Court will hear former Maharashtra Home Minister Anil Deshmukh's plea seeking permission and protection from any coercive action in the money laundering case registered against him by the Enforcement Directorate. Next segment is about Delhi High Court. While dismissing the bail appeals of two directors of a Delhi-based real estate firm, a city court said that when the country was facing a huge economic crisis on account of numerous scams which are having a disastrous impact on the state, efforts to establish the economy, a serious view has to be taken of economic offences which show a distressingly growing tendency. The Delhi High Court has granted anticipatory bail to a woman accused of sexually assaulting a minor boy, saying she already joined investigation and her custodial interrogation was not required. The Delhi High Court asked the Delhi government to file a reply on a petition seeking to resume all weekly markets with precautions and COVID-19 appropriate behavior or provide financial assistance to street vendors. The next segment is for Bombay High Court. The staffers of Air India Engineering Services Limited, a wholly owned subsidiary of Air India, moved Bombay High Court recently against the company's decision to set aside a part of their salary to clear outstanding provident fund and tax dues. The court granted a 3-week stay on implementation of the management's decision. Senior IPS officer Parambir Singh filed a petition in the Bombay High Court on Wednesday challenging an order issued by one-member inquiries commission set up by the Maharashtra government to probe into allegations of corruption against former Home Minister Anil Deshmukh, directing the former police commissioner of Mumbai to appear before it for deposition. Observing that people have to earn their livelihood, the Bombay High Court on Monday said that all these who are vaccinated must be allowed to travel by Mumbai's local train. The next segment is about Allahabad High Court, making a crucial observation on the need for a specific legal framework to deal with cases of sexual exploitation of women. Allahabad High Court exhorted the legislation to bring a law to punish those who obtain consent to establishing sexual relationship with women on false promise of marriage. Next, we have Madras High Court. The Madras High Court declared the law enacted by the Tamil Nadu government banning online betting games like Rummy and Poker as ultra vires of the constitution. The next segment is for Kerala High Court. The petition also alleged that the Kerala High Court erred in understanding the distinction between backward communities and minority communities. The state government had formed a committee headed by Justice J.B. Koshi to study the backwardness of the Christianity community. The miscellaneous news for today are: the Union government proposed to amend the Income Tax Act to end controversial retrospective tax demand. The move came after back-to-back tax disputes with Cairn Energy and Vodafone Group last year. India's Financial Crime Agency has asked Walmart Flipkart and its founders to explain why they shouldn't face a penalty of $1.35 billion for alleged violation of foreign investment laws, three sources and an agency official told Reuters. The National Commission for Protection of Child Rights issued a notice to Twitter India calling for action against Congress leader Rahul Gandhi's handle for violating the POSCO Act by posting pictures of the parents of a 9-year-old girl who was allegedly raped and murdered in the southwest Delhi's Nangal. In a detailed order rejecting Raj Kundra's bail plea in a pornography case, a magistrate court said the alleged offence is detrimental to the health of our society. It said under such circumstances, societal interest in the prosecution of a crime, which has a wider social dimension, cannot be overlooked. A London High Court has ordered the National Accountability Bureau and Pakistan government to pay a sum of $1.2 million to an asset recovery from Broadcast LLC by next week, said reports. Zoom, the video conferencing firm, has agreed to settle a class action United States privacy lawsuit for $85 million, it said on Sunday. Thank you and have a nice day. For more details, you can look in the description option.